Hello friends, a very warm welcome to King in Kitchen. Today, I am going to show you a very special recipe and delicious also made from baby corn. Do you know that baby corn has lot of health benefits? It is low in carb and high in dietary fiber. Hence, it is a magic food for weight loss and for diabetes and also gives you a good gut health. So without wasting any time, let's see the recipe. First, we need to heat a wok or a kadai. Then we'll add 2 tablespoons of oil. I'm using olive oil here, but you can use any oil of your choice. When the oil is hot, we'll add few of the whole spices. So I'm adding 3 bay leaves, cinnamon sticks, couple of green and black cardamom, and 5 to 6 cloves. We have to fry the spices in the oil for a couple of minutes in very slow flame so that the flavor of the spices gets nicely infused in the oil. This will enhance the flavor and also gives a very nice taste to the recipe. Then we'll add 4 medium onions finely chopped. The quantity which I am making here is for 8 people. Adjust the quantity based on number of people you are making this dish. We'll saute it till the color changes or till it becomes translucent. It will require 3 to 4 minutes of sauteing. And then we'll add 2 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste. These are freshly grounded ginger garlic paste. This will also help to enhance the flavor. We have to saute it till the rawness of the ginger garlic goes away. So we'll have to saute for 3 to 4 minutes in medium flame. Then we'll start adding the masala powders. We'll add 2 teaspoons of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of cumin powder, 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 tablespoon of red chili powder, and finally 1 teaspoon of garam masala powder. After adding all the masala powders, we will give it a nice mix. We'll add 1/2 cup of water. We're adding water so that the masalas doesn't get burned. Then we will allow it for a boil. When it starts to boil, we'll add the baby corns. I'm using 500 gram of baby corn here. Again, you can adjust the quantity based on number of people. We have to stir it nicely so that the masalas are well coated in the baby corns. Then we'll add 1 cup of water. This will help in the cooking process of the baby corn. Do note that if you want a good taste and lesser cooking time, you should always go for a fresh and tender baby corns. If they are not tender and if they are not fresh, then it will increase the cooking time and also the taste won't be great. So while the baby corn is being cooked, we will prepare the tomato gravy. For that, we'll need 4 medium tomatoes. And along with that, we'll grind 8 to 10 cashews and 8 almonds. We have soaked it in water for a couple of hours. We blend it to a smooth paste. And once the baby corns are well cooked, we'll add salt as per taste. And then we'll add the tomato paste. Then after that, we will allow it to cook for another 5 minutes so that the tomatoes are also nicely cooked. Once the tomatoes are cooked, we are almost done. We'll add freshly chopped coriander leaves. And our baby corn masala is ready. I hope you would have enjoyed this recipe.
Do try this at home, as this recipe is very tasty and healthy also.
And if you like the recipe, do click on the like button and let me know your feedback in the comment section. And if you're watching the video for the first time, then do subscribe my channel as well. Thank you.